Hey, I'm Vlad with Verge here at CES 2018, and the phone I have in front of me is the first one to have a fingerprint sensor integrated into the display. And it actually worked. So this is the first phone to have the fingerprint sensor integrated into the display. So it's right in this area down here, which is available to use as you would with any other smartphone display. But when you lock the phone and you want to unlock it, it turns into a fingerprint sensor. It works exactly like the capacitive fingerprint sensor you might have seen on an Apple iPhone or Samsung Galaxy S, whatever. But the difference and the advantage now is that you have these ultra-thin bezels, top and bottom on the phone, but you still have the fingerprint sensor right at the front where it used to be and where, for a lot of people, it should be. If you have no bezels, you have nowhere to put it, so a lot of companies had to come up with compromises. Samsung's solution was to put it on the back, but way over here on the side, which was terrible ergonomically. Apple's solution was to just forego Touch ID entirely on the iPhone X, neither of which was really ideal. There were many reports that Samsung and Apple were trying to integrate it into the display itself under the OLED panel, and that's exactly what Vivo has done here with the help of Synaptics. Vivo is the first company to introduce this. It's very likely that there'll be others following on for the rest of the year in 2018, and it's really impressive. It works exactly as the usual capacitive fingerprint sensor does, but it's just integrated into the display. And it feels a little bit magical because you're using the display as you would on any other phone, but when you lock the phone and you're trying to unlock it, you put your finger on it and it authenticates you. It does the usual biometric authentication. It's optical, like the previous stuff. Now, this only works with OLED panels because it's optical, and there's a Synaptics sensor down here at the bottom which looks through the OLED dots. This wouldn't work with an LCD because that requires a backlight which would block that recognition. So you'll only be able to find this on smartphones with OLED displays coming up in the rest of this year. The only difference relative to the usual fingerprint sensors is this one seems to be a little bit slower. It isn't quite as lightning fast as something like you would get on the previous iPhones or the OnePlus 5T and so on, but it's tolerably slower. It's not something that really slows you down. Even though it's not terribly well known globally, Vivo is actually one of the world's biggest smartphone manufacturers owing to a lot of success in its native market of China. This company is the first to come out with this Synaptics integrated fingerprint sensor solution, but I'm confident that there'll be a whole bunch of others joining it as we go through the year 2018. The phone that we're looking at here at CES is very close to the final product. It has an aluminum unibody, no fingerprint sensor on the back because obviously it's integrated into the display itself. And I'm liking the fact that it has a headphone jack, so thumbs up for that. But I'm noticing right now there's a headphone jack, there's a micro USB port, which doesn't make much sense to me. USB-C is the standard of the future, it's reversible, it's better in almost every single way. And this being Vivo's next flagship and having this brand new kind of futuristic technology, it makes sense that Vivo would give it the full top spec treatment. So this might not be the phone you end up buying with a fingerprint sensor integrated directly into its display, but I'm confident that the technology itself, once you try it, is something that a whole bunch of people are going to want and like, in part because it's so futuristic feeling. You know, it's a technology that used to be on a discrete, separate piece of hardware, now integrated directly into the display. It's seamless and it's kind of beautiful. So for more technology like this, follow us here at CES 2018 on theverge.com and youtube.com/theverge.